This is R.D. Sharma Solution, Class 11, Chapter 29, Limits. This is very short answer question. So, all these questions, mostly we have done. And here it will be some, you know, negative and positive limit. And the answer of this question is, does not exist. How? See, remember, whenever we have this under root, whenever it comes out, things comes out, it will be plus minus. So 1 minus cos 2x is 2 sine square x. So under root 2 you can take out sine square x. So whenever we take out, see, x square, that means it can be plus minus x, because minus x square is also x square and plus x square is also x square. So root 2 plus minus x by x. So one time we are going to take it as plus, other time you will have to take it as negative. That is, left hand limit and right hand limit, both we have to check. So left hand limit I am taking first, and then we are taking right hand limit. So this is limit x tends to 0. So x is 0 minus h in this case, and x equal to 0 plus h, which we have been doing for the left hand limit and right hand limit. So root 2 is what? Root 2, let it be root 2. And I am putting 0 minus h as sine 0 minus h by 0 minus h. Sine 0 minus h by 0 minus h. Here you have sine 0 plus h divided by 0 plus h. 0 plus h. So what do you get here? Sine minus theta. Sine minus theta is what? Sine minus theta is minus sine theta. So minus sine theta minus sine h divided by minus h. But this thing which we are seeing is in mod. This is modulus, because whenever you take under root out, it will be mod. And this we have to do in all the questions, because it was not required, so we didn't do it. But always in this type of question, you have to take a mod. Mod of minus h sin h is plus sin h. So you have minus h in the denominator, so sin h by h and negative. So now apply the limit sin h by h and negative of this. Limit h tends to 0, so minus root 2 only, because root 2 was there, sin h by h and negative was there. What about this right hand side? See, this is sin 0 plus h by 0 plus h, since it is in the mod or absolute value. So you have sin h by h, so you have root 2. So one time it is coming as root 2, one time it is coming as minus root 2. So that means it's not matching. So this is not matching. The next question, this is limit x tends to 0 minus, so it's clearly written that it is 0 minus. So this is greatest integer function. So 0 minus means you have to put 0 minus h here, x as 0 minus h. So when you put 0 minus h, what are you going to get? See, 0 minus h, so you are subtracting something from 0. You are subtracting something from 0. Okay, now applying the limit. So what does it mean? Now let me show you it on the number line. So you are saying that this is 0 minus something, 0 minus h, right? So this is 0 to minus 0 to minus 1, and there is something which we are subtracting from 0. So it has to be lower 1. Greatest integer function always take the lower 1. So minus 1 is the answer. Please remember, this is, if I am putting 3.2, it is between 3 and 4, it will always be 3. If you are taking 3.8, it will also always be 3. Now, 0 plus, same thing we are going to do here, 0 plus. So 0 plus means we are going to add 0 plus h. So now we are adding something to 0. H tends to 0, that is 0 plus h, so something we are adding to 0. So how do we get it? This is 0 plus h. So you know, 0 plus h is h only, because if you are adding 0 with anything, it's going to be h. But you are adding 0 and it goes to 1, but the greatest integer function is always take it as 0. Now question number 4, x minus greatest integer function x. So x minus mod x. So x tends to 1 minus means x is going to be 1 minus. 1 minus means what? You are going to put 1 minus h. 1 minus means 1 minus h. Okay. 1 minus 1 plus would have been 1 plus h. Okay. So you have in x, I am putting 1 minus h minus greatest integer function, you have 1 minus h. Okay. So this is 1 minus h, that is you are subtracting something from 1. When you are subtracting something from 1, as I said, you have to take 0 value. Wherever you come, between 0 and 1, it has to be 0. So this is 0, going to be 0. And 1 minus h, limit h tends to 0. So 1 minus 0 is going to be 1. This is 1, it will be the answer. Now, fifth is, write the value of, so x tends to 0 minus, what does it mean? X equals 0 minus h. So what is the function sine 0 minus h divided by 0 minus h? Now h is tending to 0. Okay. The number line, you are subtracting something from 0. When you are subtracting something from 0, that is you are going to go to minus 1. So 0 minus h, greatest integer function will always be minus 1. So minus 1 it will be, and this also 0 minus h, minus 1. So this will be sine minus 1. Okay. 0 minus h. So you have sine 1 minus sine minus 1. And sine minus theta is minus sine theta. Sine minus theta is minus sine theta. So you have sine 1 here. So sine 1 by this gets cancelled. Only sine 1 will come. Sine 1 is going to be the answer. Now question number 6. Now sine x by x minus pi. Sine x minus x by pi. So what we'll do? We'll do the x tends to pi, we'll do the left hand limit and right hand limit both. So in place of x, we are going to put pi minus h also and pi plus h also. Both we are going to do. So x is pi minus h. The same thing you are going to do for the right hand limit also. So sine pi minus h, x is pi minus h minus pi. So pi gets cancelled. Sine 180 minus theta. What is sine 180 minus theta? Add sugar to coffee if you take. Then pi minus theta, sine pi minus theta is sine theta. And see, you don't have to right hand limit also. You can see that it is in front of you. So sine pi minus h by minus h. As I said, sine pi minus h, sine 180 minus theta is all school to college or add sugar to coffee, 180 minus theta. So this is going to be plus only sine h, and this is minus h, minus h. So limit h tends to 0. So sine by h is 1 for limit, and minus 1 will come. Even if you take pi plus h, sine 180 plus theta is minus sine theta, right? Tan is positive here, only sine will be negative. So minus sine plus sine h and divided by pi plus h minus h. So pi gets cancelled, you have h, and sine h by h is going to be 1 and minus it will be. So both cases you are going to get minus 1. Now sine x by x tends to infinity. Now the limit plays a very different role here. Okay. So what do we get here? The answer of this question is, 7th is 0. So how it is going to be 0? Remember, anything multiplied by 0 will always be 0, whether it is infinity or anything. So x tends to infinity, let us get rid of this infinity first. It will be very good if we deal with x tends to 0 or some other number. So you can put x as 1 by y. When x is tending to 0, when x is tending to 0, infinity, y is tending to 0. You can just replace this, y equals 1 by x. X tends to infinity, y tends to 0. You just apply it here, limit y tends to 0, and you have this sine. In place of x, we are putting 1 by y, and here also we are putting x 1 by y. Y goes up. So when y goes up, it is with sine 1 by y. Whatever is coming in with y, with sine, how does it matter? Because it is y is 0. So anything multiplied by y or which is a 0 is going to be 0. But we need to check, just to show the examiner, that we will deal with this sine 1 by something also. So we will use the left hand limit and right hand limit both, just to confirm that it's in fact zero. So we'll apply this LHL and RHL. Okay, so I'll just show you here only why we are putting as 0 minus h, why here we are putting 0 plus h. So when we put 0 minus h, 1 by 0 minus h, sine minus theta is minus sine theta, so it will be minus sine 1 by h, and minus, when minus goes outside, it will be minus minus cancel, only h will remain. So h is going to be 0, and whatever is value, you know, whatever you put inside sine, it will always be the value minus 1 to 1. Sine theta will always be between minus 1 and 1. The domain of one of sine inside sine, that is sine theta is anything, but the range is always minus 1 to 1. So on the right hand side or right hand limit also, same thing, that the sine, whatever you put inside, it will be minus 1 and 1, but the main thing is what is outside, which is h, and h is tending to 0. So sine 1 by h here, even if you put 0 plus h, this is h is 0. And whatever you put here, as I said, it doesn't matter, it will be always between minus 1 and plus 1. Minus 1 and plus 1. Because the domain is all real number. But the range is always minus 1 to 1. Okay. It can be whatever value. That you have to understand very well. This question is all about understanding that sign anything inside will be minus 1 and plus 1, and because 0 is coming outside, it will be 0. The next one is question number 8. Here we have absolute value modulus. So limit extends to 2 mod x minus 2 by x minus 2. So what we have to do here is, we'll take the left hand limit and then we'll take the right hand limit. And we'll try to show whether they are equal or not. So first we'll put x as, if it is x tends to 2, so we'll put x as 2 minus h. And here we are going to write 2 plus h. This is what you have to do. So what we are going to get here, 2 minus h minus 2 divided by 2 minus h minus 2. So 2 gets cancelled. This is minus h, and minus h is going to be, minus x is going to be x for mod. And 2 gets cancelled. You have minus h here. Now h gets cancelled. So you have a minus 1 as left hand limit, left hand side. So we are applying the limit, you know this limit h tends to 0. Now putting x as 2 plus h, 2 plus h minus 2 inside absolute value, and then you have 2 plus h minus 2. So you have h here, and mod h, mod x is equal to x. So h by h. So here you are going to get 1. So one time you are getting negative 1, one time you are getting positive 1. LHL, RHL not equal, that means limit is not existing. Limit is not existing. Next is question number 9. So it is in degree. First of all, we have to convert this degree into radian. All this relationship only is there when we have in radians. So 2 pi radian is equal to 360 degrees. So pi radian is 180 degrees. So in order to convert this degree into radian, you have to multiply this degree into pi by 180. So we have x degree, we have to convert it. Sine x degree, so pi by 180, multiply this x by pi by 180. Okay. Now this is x. Now we have to introduce this pi by 180 here. In order to do this, we have to have a pi by 180 here also. Now, just apply the limit sine theta by theta. What is sine theta by theta? It's going to be 1. What is remaining? Pi by 180. So, pi by 180 is the answer here. See, all the question answers which we have done in the previous different chapters, VSAQ and MCQs are not been done. Because all the questions which we have done in the questions, they are repeated. See this question, this is also repeated. That is why from 23rd, that is the straight lines, we have started doing these MCQs and VSAQs. Question number 10 now. Sine x by under root x. So what are we going to do here? It's x tends to 0 minus. 0 minus means we have to apply the limit 0 minus h, left hand limit. So 0 minus h, because clearly given, it x tends to 0 minus. So this under root 0 minus h. As I said, 0 minus h we have put, 0 minus h. If it would have been 0 plus, we would have been putting this 0 plus h. So sine 0 minus h, that is sine minus h by sine minus theta is minus sine theta. So minus sine h. What about this one? Under root minus h. So under root or negative, is it defined? If we are discussing complex number, then it is okay. But here it is not defined. So this limit does not exist in this case. We are not talking about complex numbers. In this scenario, this limit does not exist. Undefined, because under root 0, minus 0 or minus infinity, minus anything is undefined. Question number 11 here. Sin x by under root 1 plus x minus 1. So let me do it here. You just have to multiply it by rationalization factor RF. Multiply numerator denominator with the plus sign of this one. Denominator you have a square minus b square. So 1 plus x minus 1. And numerator you have sin x and root 1 plus x plus 1. So x is all what you got in the denominator. Sin x by x is going to be 1 for limits. Here under root 1 plus x plus 1, x is 0. So under root 1 plus 1, that is 2, is going to come. Question number 12 now. So we have this limit x tends to minus infinity. So what we have seen in the previous questions, if you have followed all the exercise, we don't deal with minus infinity often. So what we will do, we will try to deal with plus infinity. Plus infinity, not minus infinity, right? It's quite easy, because x is tending to infinity. Let us have m which is equal to n minus x. You can have any variable you choose. So m is minus x. For that, if this is minus infinity, x tend to minus infinity, it will be m tends to infinity. So we have positive infinity, the solution will be better to solve. The only reason is that. So now multiply this by rationalization factor. This whole will remain. In place of plus, we'll use negative. So numerator will be a square minus b square. So a, this minus 3m whole square. And then you have a square minus b square. So this is, so under root it is there. So under root of this square is 9m square plus m. And then you have this denominator we'll take later. Minus 3m square is 9m square. Minus 9m square minus m. So this 9m square, 9m square get cancelled. You have minus m only in the numerator. In the denominator you already have this minus 3m minus under root 9m square plus m. Okay. So highest power is what? M. So let us divide numerator denominator by m. And you know when you have m inside under root, you have to take m square. So you have minus 3 minus m by m minus 3 by m. So it is minus 3. So I am taking m square here. 9 m square by m square is 9. As I said, m you have to take inside. So you have to take m square. So m by m square is 1 by m. 1 by m. Now m is tending to infinity. M is tending to infinity. Just take this as 0. This gets cancelled. Minus 1 by minus 3 minus of under root 9. Under root 9 is what? Under root 9 is 3. 3 square is 9. So minus 1 by minus 3 and minus 3. So minus 1 by minus 6. So you have 1 by 6. 1 by 6. So question number 13. So how do we do this? I am writing factorial n. N plus 1, writing it as n plus 1 factorial n. And here also you have n plus 1 factorial. So you have n plus 1 and factorial n. Then you have n plus 2 factorial as n plus 2, n plus 1 and factorial n. So numerator, take factorial n common. So inside this you have 1 plus n plus 1. And in the denominator you have n plus 1 factorial n. So n plus 1 factorial n we are taking constant. You have 1 here. and this goes, n plus 2 will remain, n plus 2. So what do you get? Factorial n, this is n plus 2, this gets, this factorial n you can cancel. You have n plus 1 here, and this is n plus 3, n plus 3. So what do you see here is the denominator power is more than the numerator power. And we have seen already in this question that this kind of situation, this kind of thing will give what? But I'll do it. So I'm multiplying the denominator. Now dividing numerator, denominator, the highest power is n square. So let us divide it. Okay. What it is going to come, you know it very well, but I'm going to do it. We'll divide it by the highest power, which we have learned. So n square by n, n square by n square, divide everything by n square. So this is 1 by n, and this is going to be 2 by n square, and this is going to be 1, this is 4 by n, and this is by 3 by n square, okay. So now, wherever we have n infinite in the divisor, so it's going to be 0. 1 by infinite is 0. So this is going to, numerator is 0 plus 0, denominator is 1 plus 0 plus 0. So 0 by 1 is 0. This is going to be 0 is the answer. Now question number 14. 2x minus pi by cos x. And LHL, RHL we are going to take, x is tending to pi by 2. So what does it mean? We'll put x as pi by 2 minus h in one case and pi by 2 plus h in another case. And the answer would be some value, and that value has to be equivalent. Either you take LHL or RHL. This is very important. So okay. So x is pi by 2 minus h, and x is pi by 2 plus h here. So put it here, 2 into pi by 2 minus h, and then you have minus pi divided by cos pi by 2 minus h, and then here we have same thing here, but with pi by 2 plus h, pi by 2 plus h, 2 into pi by 2 plus h, and minus pi divided by cos pi by 2 plus h. So what do you see here? Add sugar to coffee, or all school to college. So we'll deal with this. Pi by 2 minus h. Multiply this, 2 into pi by 2 minus h. So you have pi minus 2h minus pi. Cos 90 minus theta is sine theta, sine h. This gets cancelled, minus 2h by sine h, and sine h by h is 1, limit, and applying limit only minus 2 will come. What about this one? 2 into 2 pi by 2 is pi only, pi plus h minus h. But what is cos 90 plus theta? It's sine theta, but it will be minus sine theta, right? Because cos is not positive in the second quadrant. So, 2, this pi, 2h it is, pi gets cancelled. 2h by minus sine pi, sine h, sorry. So, h by sine h is going to be 1, and you have minus in the denominator, minus 2 will come. So, this is minus 2, left hand limit, right hand limit, both are same, so the answer will be minus 2. Question number 15. What do we have here? 1 plus 2 plus 3 dot 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 n, that is we have a series, and we know how to solve this series, and n plus 1 by 2, this is the sum of the series, n square is already there in the denominator, n square, so n gets cancelled, half you can just take it outside, we are going to use it later, n by n, this is, you have n plus 1 by n, now you can divide it like this, n by n plus 1 by n, so this is 1 plus 1 by n, and this is limit n tends to infinity, this 1 by infinity is 0, So one will come and half is already there. So half will come. So the final answer is going to be half. Okay, this is all about this VSAQ. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.